The Sanctified Life, Chapter 4, The Fiery Furnace. In the same year that Daniel and his companions entered the service of the king of Babylon, events occurred that severely tested the integrity of these youthful Hebrews and proved before an idolatrous nation the power and faithfulness of the God of Israel. While King Nebuchadnezzar was looking forward with anxious forebodings to the future, he had a remarkable dream by which he was greatly troubled, and his sleep broke from him. Daniel 2 verse 1. But although this vision of the night made a deep impression on his mind, he found it impossible to recall the particulars. He applied to his astrologers and magicians, and with promises of great wealth and honor commanded them to tell him his dream and its interpretation. But they said, "Tell thy servants the dream, and we will shew the interpretation." Verse 4. The king knew that if they could really tell the interpretation, they could tell the dream as well. The Lord had in his providence given Nebuchadnezzar this dream, and had caused the particulars to be forgotten, while the fearful impression was left upon his mind, in order to expose the pretensions of the wise men of Babylon. The monarch was very angry and threatened that they should all be slain if, in given time, the dream was not made known. Daniel and his companions were to perish with the false prophets, but, taking his life in his hand, Daniel ventures to enter the presence of the king, begging that time may be granted that he may show the dream and the interpretation. To this request, the monarch accedes, and now Daniel gathers his three companions, and together they take the matter before God, seeking for wisdom from the source of light and knowledge. Although they were in the king's court, surrounded with temptation, they did not forget their responsibility to God. They were strong in the consciousness that his providence had placed them where they were, that they were doing his work, meeting the demands of truth and duty. They had confidence toward God. They had turned to him for strength when in perplexity and danger, and he had been to them an ever-present help. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 4, The Fiery Furnace.